Hello everybody to this behind the scenes slash yeah behind the scenes video. This is not really a commentary video at all. This is a talk about my latest video being the Isaac Hook re-review. If you haven't checked that out, I'll put a link in the description. Basically what this video is, it's supposed to be talking about like the kind of the production slash behind the scenes plus a little bit of bonus material as I go through this. So this isn't really a commentary video at all, because I mean, I guess there's no real point in doing that. And also, I wanted to, this video is mainly made so that I can show you, because in the video, the original re-review, in the original re-review video, I stated that I actually had old pieces of audio from my original. So originally I was planning on making this video way back when I got my Blue Yeti mic for the very first time, which was a very long time ago. I actually have the script for the original, what the original review was gonna be. I'm gonna pull it up right now so you all can see it, if I can find it, that is. Yeah, here it is. I found it. So yeah, as you can see, first of all, this thing's in Comic Sans, which, yeah, I should be sentenced to death for this, but oh well, what are you gonna do? But yeah, so basically, as you can see as well, the video itself is supposed to be laid out a lot differently than how it was originally going to be. So, the actual script itself, which, fun fact, in some portions, you can very rarely, well, not very rarely, but you can see, actually, the script for the video in the original video itself, if you look hard enough. But yeah, as you can see, the original script clocks in at 20 pages long, and it's every word for word. The black text is colored for, like, dialogue scenes like this, where I'm talking into my mic. The blue is being for live action portions, and red is for Biznik's scenes. And then the last one, which is mainly down here, there's a part, yeah, these yellow texts, which I didn't use as often, but those basically were for scenes where it requires different voices, aka mainly Golden Freddy and Eve Ghost Boom's voice at the end of the video. But yeah, with this original script, I instead, I had an intro, like, all thought out, but the freaking, the thing was differently structured. So instead, I had the videos, and I had bulletin points talking about, what I wanted to talk about. So, for example, here, AVAG's Gone Gone Gone, we have parody the intro, talk about how bad the intro is. So before talking about the video, let's talk about the actual review. Talk about how bad the review is, and how ironic, and unironically good it is. Alright, let's get into the video, talk about how good the animation is, talk about the character designs, other two characters, final score. Yeah, that was it. So I basically was gonna do unfiltered, basically, technically just improv stuff, but I would have bulletin points to make sure I remember what I'm talking about so I don't tread on for too long. Because this old re-review script was at a time when I was starting to make scripts. My most earliest script, which was I talked about in the re-review video, I don't know if I still have this. But, like, my first script I made was for the ZQEC 37 Season 1 review, which I guess I deleted. So, unfortunately, that thing is lost media. But yeah, the script itself was not that good, because it was basically just me regurgitating my thoughts and with, like, little to zero jokes in the video. So I structured a little differently with some advice from Jada to instead have it where I bullet pointed. So it still has that kind of improv, I can still think of good comedy, while at the same time I remember what I'm talking about. However, honestly, I do not think this is a good idea for, like, structuring, reviews, especially. Like, with the reviews, you definitely need a script for, like, an actual script. It's just, I needed to be better with making the scripts themselves, and that's what happened. I eventually found out how to make an actual good script, so there's that. Anyways, let's move down the list here. So we got awkward tunes. Oh yeah, by the way, I never mentioned this in the original video, but I always called, in the original review for the Finale Shake It Off video, I actually called awkward tunes cringy tunes. I don't know why I did that, but I did. Talk about how bad the review is and how good it, how it goes on for so long. Then talk about how bad the video is, final score. Then talk about the remake. Okay, talk, basically the same how I did. Okay, talk about how bad the review is, how I fricked up on things. If I did this now, what do you mean by frick up on things? Obviously, yes, I'm not gonna just drop the F-bomb, because I do actually want this video to be mainly completely censored, so I don't have to go and edit it. I like this video, I really just want to be minimal editing as possible. But anywho, but I don't even know what it means by frick up on things. Like, I probably know what I'm talking about, but like, back then I probably wouldn't. I probably had to go back to watch the video, and the video's like 21 minutes long, so I don't think it's a good idea. But anyways, the videos themselves, Can You Survive? Talk about how my opinions are still the same, but how I talk about them bad and how I'm a hypocrite. Yes, I do mention that. Talk about the video. For some reason, the font is completely different. You can tell that most of these are basically the same. Like, talk about review, then talk about video, then talk about review, then talk about video. Yeah, it's basically that. Why does this have 100 for... Wait, what? Wait, really? Wait, what? No way. My original review has 113. Well, I definitely know my... Something like, I don't know. What is this? Actually, my foot have... Okay, my Gone 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 video has 160 views. Are you serious that my... Oh my god. Why does this have more... What? I never even knew it had that many views. Why? The review sucks. This review is like the worst out of all of them, because it's just really boring. Hey, whatever. Which, to be honest, I'm not that big of a fan of how I settled the score for some of these, for the reviews. I say that the Can You Survive animation is better than the Smash Shake It Off video, yet the review score for it is worse, being a negative 10 instead of a negative 5. But for the Zach Huey one, yeah, the review score is a 0%, because I honestly think it was that bad. Okay, so now let's talk about the question about my reviews. The making of my old reviews and how that was not good. The character stills, where are the... Oh, yeah, because at that time, I basically was just doing SFM animations. So, I guess I was just talking about how, like, well, I don't really have the passion for making these, and I feel like it's a poor job. And I am actually planning on... I'm planning on making more reviews. I mean, in this... First of all, I plan on actually redoing, I'm gonna share this right now. I am planning on continuing the CRA, series. My first video, yes, we know the Babin and Castillo video got deleted, but I am planning on redoing it, later on down the line, and you'll eventually see why when I decide to finally upload, the video. But also, I am planning on having my first character, probably my first character is going to be the Dodo Bird. Who, spoilers, I plan on, he was sneak peek at the end of the Babin and Castello video. I was gonna do Babin and Castello, the Dodo Bird, and then finally I was actually gonna do the third character, who's gonna be Ralph Wolf and Sam Sheepdog. So there was gonna be a trio of Looney Tunes characters, and then I would go on to talking about different characters I wanted to talk about. But, first I wanted to have it be, a trio of the, Looney Tunes characters I liked. I should probably get to work on making that Dodo video, because, like, I actually had audio for it, but I don't think I did a good job for it. I'm probably gonna go back and, like, revise the script a little bit, and then I'll edit the video itself. And then I'll eventually go back and do Babin and Castello, and then I will, which, that video would probably be the same as the original for people who, like, didn't watch it, but, yeah. I mean, freaking, what, Pat Mac did that. He deleted his original, well, he personally, I think, deleted his, Smash Brothers Ultimate, like, characters as plushies video, and then he decided to revisit it and do it again, so that's what I'm planning on doing for the Babin and Castello. It's gonna be a little bit of a pain to redo all of that, but I don't think it would be that bad of a thing. But, yeah, and then I'll do Ralph and Sam, and then I'll do a different character entirely, who, I don't know who would be next, but, I'll think of someone. But anywho, yeah. Now, I want to talk about a few things here, like, one, why I decided to finally have character stills. If you look in the video itself, I finally, have character stills for the Isaac persona, and I mean, isn't it a little obvious, like, why I wanted to do this? Like, it's honestly not that, like, hard to tell why I did this, because, well, I wanted character stills for the longest time. In some of my reviews I eventually did, like revising them, like the Once Bitten review or the USA Sonic analysis video, I just used gameplay footage, mainly Sonic gameplay, because it's very easily accessible to me. And I thought it was fine to use gameplay. Like, people have done that before, like Optimus, and to an extent, Penguin Z0, Moist Critical, he did that with some of his past videos. I honestly think it's fine to use gameplay. However, I don't know, I feel like that just makes you look soulless and just, like, faceless. Like, I want, like, and besides, I already have a character. I have the freaking Isaac Cook, I have the cookie guy, I have him. So, like, I want to use him in my videos. Okay, I want to do that. Oh yeah, by the way, fun fact, the thumbnail, which I'll probably just put up an image of right now, it was actually supposed to look different. It was supposed to be like me, my persona, like in a spotlight, and then all the OC, like all the creators are surrounding me, looking like peeved at me. But I decided to drop that because I don't know, I just couldn't be bothered to draw all their personas, so that's why it was changed to something like the X Factors with let me tell you Zachuie's OC was very easy to draw because I've drawn that version of Bonnie before. How do you say Laika's OC was super easy to draw. You're all shockingly enough. Ava's OC, why does her OC have such messy hair? It's a pain, let me tell you that much. It was a pain to draw the hair. I don't even think I did that good of a job. But anywho. So now let's talk about scrapped stuff, because I don't really have that much. What you see in the video is exactly what it is on the original script. However, there is two moments in the video, two points I want to talk about that are scrapped, for better or for worse. You'll see why. So at the end of the Shake It Off section, where Isaac and Biznik do that whole, no it's not, yes it is, no it's not, yes it is, yes it is, no it's not, yes it is, no it's not. Originally, there was supposed to be, Biznik, says, you know, it is funny and it will forever be funny. And then I say, all right, yeah, you can go. And then what was supposed to happen was there was supposed to be an outside shot of Biznik. Like, yeah, I did that, haha, good for me. And then he eventually realized what he did, so he slams open the door, and he's like, you son of a... But for some reason, I didn't get that part recorded, so the punchline of the joke was basically gone, which kind of sucks, but oh well, I guess. I don't even know, I can't remember now if I actually... I don't even remember if I actually did record that part with Biznik. Either A, I just straight up didn't record it, and I'm getting the Mandela effect, or B, I did record it, but the video was paused, like the camera footage was paused, so I didn't capture it, because that's what did happen in the Garbage and Recycle video squeezing through with Wario's section. Wario's scene was supposed to be a lot more expanded with him throwing up a bomb at Garbage and Recycle, but it was all cut because the video was paused. Also, another joke that was so unfortunately cut because the video was paused at the wrong moment was Garbage going, I got an idea! Which is like irony because Recycle did it at the beginning of the video. It makes more sense in context if you actually watched the video, but anywho. Another thing as well is that at the end of the sugar section, it's kind of hard to talk about this, so if you want to skip ahead, I will leave a timestamp to, like, when, this section is over, because it does get a little, like, it does get pretty dark. It does get very dark, actually. So, at the end of sugar section, I was going to make a joke. So, Sugar made a video a long time ago talking about, like a Draw My Life type video, and the video is now unlisted, thank goodness, but the video basically talked about, I don't really remember all of it though, it's been a long time ago since I, known this, knowledge, but basically I think it was something where, like, she was abused, and then she actually was thinking about committing suicide, killing herself driving her car off a cliff. She full blown's like, not really, well, yeah, animates this. She it's full blown animated of this. However, she decides against this. This is obviously super dark and a tragedy. And for some reason in my messed up mind, I was planning on making a joke where I was originally going to go, oh, hey, she does, oh, hey, you know, she did, like, story time, she did a Draw My Life video once, and, you know what, we don't really need to talk about that anymore, let's move on. And then I planned on having it where my character was sitting in the car next to Sugar. Yeah, first of all, the joke already itself is just kind of boring. It's like very bland, dark humor. But the fact that I was gonna. Oh, now, keep in mind, I never draw this. I only had this in my mind. I never drew this. So if you want to see Isaac next to Sugar about to kill herself, too bad. You're not getting that. Thank you. But, all right, well, this video is stupid now because I did that. But, anywho, yeah, obviously, this was just plain dark and just kind of messed up. Like, this was, like, I realized that I tried making the joke, like, as, like, dark, but at the same time, not insensitive. But I feel like it was just way too, like, way too mean. It was way too cruel. Because it's not like something where I'm like, oh, hey, you stink like an Velian because you made a freaking animation of Freddy Fazbear and I don't like it. Like, obviously with stuff like that, it's just a video. It's just a video. It's just animated, haha, Freddy Fazbear singing song. But with something like that, it's way too serious. If she's animating herself that she was about to kill herself, and like. I don't know. Like, obviously, that's just morbid. That's just messed up. So, I eventually decided to just tweak the joke completely, just switch it around entirely to make it where, instead I just say, nowadays she's making story time videos. Those are shit. And then that's it. That's the joke. I just state, hey, I'm not that big of a fan of, I don't really care for story time videos. Yeah. You just get a nice, simple joke. That's also a cut joke, which I think is pretty funny. So, yeah. Now, hey, guess what? You're out of the section where I talk about dark stuff. Yeah, another fun fact actually is that originally the actual script itself was way more. Now you can tell I obviously have a sailor's mouth in this video, but obviously it's all like bleeped out, so it doesn't really matter that much. But originally there was a lot more swearing in the original version. Like in this original script, I swear way more often. But I did decide, hey, okay, I'm gonna tone it down a little bit because I feel like there's way too many points in it where I just swear. Like, the one I can instantly think of is actually the scene with Biznik and me going, no, it's not yet. Yes, it is. Basically, so before Biznik was supposed to leave and then open the door, and he's like, you son of a. Originally, he shouts, yes, it is. It will forever be funny and always be funny. He was also gonna say, Dipshin McGee. And then there's also other points where I just like swear way more often. Like, I can instantly think of one because this really messed up with the script like me voicing over it. The part where I do the Benny Hill section on the AVAG How to Play Golf video. Right after I say, why are you taking so long talking about how Ava's introduced last? Like, no one gives a sh. I was gonna say, my thinking reenactment of golf, so I was gonna include the F word there, but I decided against it because I just felt like it was really unnecessary. Like, they're. Oh, yeah. Another thing that is also actually a scrapped element of the script, I completely forgot about this one. So, originally, me singing the Can You Survive, song was gonna be way longer. I would have continued more after the Left You Here All Alone line and end at the chorus where it's like, can you survive these nights, dead or alive, Five Nights at Freddy's? Yeah, that's how it was gonna go. And then also I was gonna say at the end, look, you get it, I'm better at singing, I'm great, okay? And then also, the line for Biznik where he's like, for some reason, I'm still standing here, was actually ad-libbed. That was not in the original script. Yeah, that's basically all I wanted to talk about, I guess. I don't know. No, yeah, the scene with the Finn's muzzle thingy, freaking went on way longer than I thought it would, but hey, whatever. That recording was like really bad. But anyway, I think that's it. So now I'm gonna show you all. I'm gonna give you all, because as far as I know, I still have all the original audio for that original review. So without further ado, I will show you all the original audio. Keep in mind, this is all just audio. There's no editing. I'm not editing anything. The only thing I'm gonna properly edit is I'm just gonna like freaking, I don't know, just show you it. Yeah. And then there's gonna be like a probably like the artwork I did for each section of the video, and that's about it. So. Yeah, and now, signing off. Yeah, after all the audio is done, the video is going to be over. So, signing off, thank you guys so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you all later. Goodbye. Now, I'm going to go rip out my vocal cords. Okay. Here we go. Review script act one. If you look on my channel, you see that I do animations. So you could say that I'm an animation channel. But in actuality, I always wanted to make my channel about skits and reviews. I want to make funny skits about my characters or pre-existing ones and reviews. Take two. If you look on my channel... Take three. If you look on my channel, you see that I do animations, so you could say I'm an animation channel, but in actuality, I always wanted to make my channel about skits and reviews. I want to make funny skits about my characters or pre-existing ones and reviews, not just about movies and games, but also YouTube videos. But the problem is that with skits, you know, they need stories, and I don't really have any ideas for skits and reviews. I'll save that one for the end. But recently, I finally got a snowball mic, and now I can actually make, you know, good videos. So to celebrate this moment, I'm going to look back at all my old reviews and re-review all the older videos. I'm going to be going back to Gone 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 all the way up to ZackHuey37's Season 1 review. So yes, we're not looking at the reproduction team and Teen Movie Star action figure review. Good lord, that's a long name. And onwards, because I think a few still hold up. And also, there's some videos I won't be looking at, because they don't deserve to be re-reviewed. These being the Isaac Hook Iceberg videos, FNAF AR Every Skin Review, and Jack's Pacific Sonic the Hedgehog Supersonic and Mighty Action Figure Review, What Is With These Long Names Me, and Ultimate Fan Night. Okay. And the worst review, it's not even a review, I don't even know what to call it, I ever made. The Isaac Hook review, every cartoon character in the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Why does this have 114 views? Jesus help me. So without further ado, let's actually go already, come on! That was beautiful, me. Brings a tear to my eye. Welcome to the Isaac Show. I hope you enjoy your stay. Now come along with us, you see, and you'll be filled with glee. Yeah, this intro sucks. Like, genuinely, it is dog crap. Like, the way I sound during it, the way I'm singing, I sound so monotone and sound like I am genuinely dying on the inside. I sound like an animatronic. Okay, this introduction is horrible. Downright horrible. Whenever I have to watch this video and I have to watch the introduction, I genuinely cringe. Like, I'm not kidding. I genuinely cringe inside my body because how bad it is. Like, good gravy. Now, to be honest, the melody, Welcome to the Isaac Show, I hope you enjoy your stay, now come along with us, you see, and you'll be filled with glee, is alright for the most part. It would be a lot better if it actually did rhyme, though, but then again, there's, like, no words that rhyme with stay, except for, like, bay, or gay, but, you know, whatever. Also, like, the thumbnail itself, like, the artwork I show, it's bad. Like, oh my god, like, Springtrap, what is that designed for Springtrap? But, anyways, actually, getting into the review, there are some parts in this video I actually genuinely liked. Like, there was some parts in the video that were actually funny. Like, I'm not kidding. For this being technically my first review, there is genuinely some funny moments in this video. You know, and I was pretty shocked. The whole, oh, Riddler, the, you know, the part where Marshall beatboxing comes in. I think that's how you pronounce the same. The Marshall beatboxing bit was pretty funny. The outro where I say, like, if there isn't 40,000 likes on this video, I will not make it number one. I'm just kidding. Like, I like how I get exaggerated, but then I tone it back with, like, subtle, like, mellow, like, voice. Like, there's some, now in the beginning of the video, I do kind of sound like I'm sick, which I could have been sick, but then, when the video progresses, I do get, like, my voice does get a lot better sounding, and I genuinely, like, try to be funny. To be honest, I genuinely am a bit funny in this video. Like, I genuinely try. It's not just me screaming at the top of my lungs for 40 minutes. You'll see that that's going to be a problem later on in the... Oh, God. But, yeah. Overall, I would say that the review portion, some parts are bad,
some parts, like for example, I swear, like I legit just say the F word, and I try to censor it, but the censoring is so poor that you could still hear it, basically, if you really tried listening for it. There's a part as well in the video where I go, where for some reason the audio's messed up, and instead of me just saying gross, I go, gross, gross! Yeah, I don't know. And there's also long pauses between the review bits and Ava's video. But there's also, another, I guess unironic funny thing in the, ironic funny thing in the video, not unironic, ironic funny thing in the video is the transition I do. So, okay, so after I, am confused about who Pimp is, I do this little, like, really garbage stock transition to, like, announce the character's name, and it has, like, it's literally just a black background with white text, and Daffy Duck singing, and for some reason, I like this transition. I don't know why. I guess it's just because it's so bad that it's good for some reason, but, yeah. Overall, I would say that this review is actually genuinely, it's not great, don't get me wrong, this is kind of a horrible review. But some of the points I make are kind of good, and I wouldn't say it's actually god-awful. If I sounded a bit more, like, you know, happy or whatever, I don't sound like that, like, you know, monotone, you know, I kind of sound like this. I genuinely think it would have been a good video, you know. There's also some points where I do kind of nitpick, which I don't like nitpicking. That's a common thing you're going to see in these older views, that I nitpick constantly. And I do actually kind of, like, call myself out in this video, like, I know it's nitpicking, I know I've been, you know, being a bit jerky, which meant I was kind of a meanie head, especially at the end of the video. I kind of really wish I didn't have my Wither Freddy still hold up a middle finger whenever he gets really angry, because I feel like that's just, like, really mean. Like, you know, I don't say Ava doesn't deserve Wither Freddy giving her the finger. Come on, grape over here loves Freddy. But, anyways, speaking of, you know, video, let's talk about the video. Okay, so, the video Gone Gone Gone, was, the song Gone 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 was made by this guy called, like, I don't know, Philip and Jaden Diner, but anyways, and, apparently, if you read the description of the original video, it says that it's apparently a stage play of all of Ava's characters, all quotations, because FNAF and Undertale characters are here. Oh, so that explains it. That explains why the weird stuff happens, like Golden Freddy, Springtrap being friends, Golden Freddy turning Flowey into Asriel, Flowey having a go. Head Big Blue existing, the characters being there. It's a stage play. With the funny story, Mark, that's no excuse, Ava. You're not getting past that. You are not getting past that lame excuse. Okay, but in all seriousness, first of all, the animation. I would say that the animation is overall pretty good. It's actually really, well made. I do think it kind of reminds me of, like, old Newgrounds animations from, like, 2000 and, like, 8. I don't know. It definitely looks like someone's more earlier works, which is alright. I would say the audio is a bit, grainy. I guess that's the word I'm looking for. The audio really kind of sounds bad. That's what I'm trying to say here. But overall, I do think the animation looks nice. I do think the colors kind of look a bit dull. Like, if they were brighter, I think it would look better. But now let's talk about, the negative parts of the video. Okay, so I kind of already mentioned it, but still. The characters crossing over. We have the FNAF characters featuring the cast from FNAF 1, all the toys from FNAF 2, Purple Guy, and Springtrap. Then we have Ava's OCs being Grape, Pimple, Grimmatchsticks, Goner, and then Undertale characters being Frisk, Chara, Papyrus, Sans, Flowey / Nazreel. Oh, and that's it. Okay. I was expecting, like Toriel, but, whatever, I guess. I don't like that. I don't like it. I mean, having FNAF and Undertale and your OCs and animation, just it's just not good. It's not even a good idea. In fact, the characters, like, barely interact with each other. Like, the OCs and FNAF characters sort of interact. The only time, like, the FNAF and Undertale characters interact is with Golden Freddy, and he turning Flowey into Azrael. That's it. So, in my opinion, it's too many characters. There's too many characters in this animation. So characters like, I don't know, like Foxy, for example, don't get, like, any screen time whatsoever. In my opinion, it's a bad idea. You should have, like, cut it down to dramatic measures. Maybe just, you know, to be honest, the cast from the Timber video, actually, in my opinion, was a decent cast of characters. It was just the four OCs, the five main guys from FNAF 1, and then Springtrap, and that was it. In my opinion, you just had those characters, and maybe, like, Sans and Papyrus. I think that would have been good. But sadly, no, we get, like, 40 freaking characters, which is a lot. Also, the character designs for some of them are weird. The style for the FNAF animatronics, I'm not a big fan of. Now, I don't know if they're actually truly animatronics in this animation, because it doesn't look like it. They look like animals. They look like anthropomorphized furry animals. And it also goes with Purple Guy, the Puppet, and Balloon Boy. These guys, they're supposed to be humans, human animatronics, and humanoid animatronics, but they're all animals for some reason. And I don't like that. It looks weird and a little bit silly. And Ava still does it. Like, later on down the line, she made Left Behind, and the baby and Ballora were animals. So, it's just not a, good design aspect. I'm not saying you have to be, like, 100% accurate to the original designs, but you could have just, you know, not made them animals. And also, Flowey having a goat head is absolutely just stupid. Like, genuinely, it is actually dumb. Like, I know he only appears for, like, what, like, 3 seconds, but still, it's really, really stupid. Like, I get he's a goat, like, goat boy, but still, come on, man. Come on, man, that's a dumb design aspect. But anyways, as well, the way Golden Freddy turns Flowey into Azrael is out, it's really dumb. Like, I say this in the video, you know, he's fire, Golden Freddy's about to light that butt. Wait, what? that line's pretty funny. Golden Freddy gets flame, puts it on Flowey, it turns to Azrael. Like, that makes any sense. Gee, I wonder, geez, am I gonna, you know, reference the thumbnails for both of these videos? The drawings I made for this video? Yes. You know, Golden Freddy's burning Flowey. Yeah, okay, this joke literally went nowhere. I'm so sorry you had to hear that. But anyways, then the ending. The ending of the video. Everyone gets heartburn and they turn into giant furry cringe beasts, as I call them for some reason. I don't have no name for them. I'll just call them Big Blue. Guess the name's whatever. Okay, so Big Blue. Okay, you want to introduce a new character. Okay, that's alright. But then you realize something. Wait a minute. This is confusing. How come you have literally almost every FNAF animatronic from, like, 2015, minus, you know, the Nightmares and the Phantoms and the Shadows, and okay, whatever. You have almost all the FNAF characters, you have, like, 4 Undertale characters, and you have your OCs inside this big freakish monster thing. Like, excuse me? Also, yes, okay, I know, okay, yes, I know, Professor, in the ending, we see Ava with all of her creations sleeping in, like, Mushroom Hill from Sonic 3 and Knuckles, but still, it's stupid. Yeah. And also, brings up another question I, for some reason, have. Is Big Blue, like, is Big Blue still canonically, like, a creation of, like, amalgamation of all these characters, or is he, like, a separate being from all of them? Because, like, he can't be an amalgamation of all of them, because, you know, the four musketeers, the four stooges are still around. So he has to be a separate character. He could be an amalgamation. Maybe that's why Freddy never appears in any of the videos. You never see Freddy X Grape again, which, thank Christ. But yeah, overall, what do I think of the actual video? The video, let's see here, I'll give it a 5 out of 10. Halfway. I do think the animation looks decent. It had a kind of interesting concept, but overall, most of it is absolutely poorly executed. executed. And I know people love this animation. I get that. Someone literally commented, like, you know, she's his hero, but still, like, bro, it's not my cup of tea. I don't even like country music. Why did I even review this video? But, my review of the video, in my opinion, gets an 8 out of 10. Genuinely, some of the stuff in there is actually funny. Like, really, really funny. And some, you know, is ironically funny. Some of it's obviously bad. Like, I really don't know why I added, like, the when I get angry, part train whistles. Isaac, whenever he gets angry, train whistles intensify. Like, what the? Like, come on, dude. But my review is actually, I think this is the only review I think we should go watch again. Because it actually genuinely was kind of funny. Yeah, that's about it. Let's move on to Let's Shake It Off, shall we? This review is so bad, I genuinely feel sleepy. It was that boring. This review sucks. Genuinely sucks. I have no idea how anyone can say that this is a good review. And it's probably a massive spit in the face, spit in the mouth, for this to be called the 400 subscriber special. Like, I am genuinely so happy that I got the 400 subscribers, but this review definitely did not need to be the 400 subscriber special. It is so, so, so bad. And I genuinely feel like going to sleep, even though it's like 2:27 p.m. by the time I'm recording this. And also, you know, I scream at the top of my lungs in this video. There's only, like, what, a couple of jokes in here that are actually funny. The first one being, the grave thing, where I die, and then I come back, and then the, nah, I'm just pulling your, beans. That was pretty funny. But why did I have to start the video with me screaming? Like, after the garbage intro, I'm like, hello guys, it's me, Isaac, back in whenever video, and then I go, oh, 400 subscribers, like, what the heck, bro, I'm not here for an ear rape video, I'm here for a review of a garbage FNAF animation. Also, it literally takes me 2 minutes to actually get into the video. It should not take you that long to actually start reviewing the video. I get, like, in the intro, I talk about, oh, you know, hey, it's cool that I got 400 subscribers. But it didn't need to be, like, 2 minutes long. Okay? And also, I go on a long tangent about, like, I shouldn't complain about this person's animation, because I don't know how to anime. Why does that matter? Who cares? Who gives a flying F-word? It does not matter at all. Just stick with the review. It doesn't matter. Stop complaining. Stop tangenting. Stop going into no man's land. Stop B-wording, whining, and moaning about stuff that nobody cares about. Shut up! But anyways, now, I remember in the end of the video, I say, oh my god, I have a massive headache. It probably wasn't because of the video, me. It was probably because you kept on moaning and whining like a 5-year-old who dropped his ice cream under a bridge. Like, Jesus, good lord. This review is horrible. And it gets worse from here, folks. This video did not needed to be, like, what, 17 minutes long? Like, it really should have only been, like, what, 4 minutes long, maybe? But anyways, let's actually, you know, get into the review, like, the video. The video is god-awful. The FNAF Shake It Off video is god-awful. It's not even qualified as an animation. It should not be qualified as an animation in the slightest. It's the most choppiest thing I've ever seen in my life. It's literally just snap into one pose, into another, and then completely the next scene. The classic and toy animatronics, they don't look completely different. No, they basically look exactly the same. Outside of having cheeks, Toy Chica having a tutu, and Toy Freddy and Bonnie having, you know, slightly different colors. Other than that, they look exactly the same. Oh, yeah, like, that's, you know, that's totally how they look in the canon games. That's how every single, you know, Freddy incarnation looks in the canon games. They're the exact same, but in a different costume. I assume. It's like the one thing from regular show where, you know, with the pixie sorcerer. But, anyways, also, the character designs look horrible. They look like deviant art dress-up up versions of the animatronics. And Mangle as well, looking like a literal spaghetti noodle. She looks like a plate of spaghetti Garfield would eat. But yeah. And also, you know, you don't need the characters' faces literally 2 centimeters away from me. Like, why are the faces so close together? Hey, guys, I think I just found my new sleep paralysis demons. Uh-huh. But yeah, genuinely, this review sucks. The video sucks. All of it sucks. I do not recommend going back to this video unless you literally feel like dying on the inside and outside. So the final score is negative 10. It is so bad. But now I actually want to talk about the remake, because I do actually talk about the remake and the original review for a little bit. How I say it's a lot better, even though, you know, there are some flaws to it, it's still better. No. You know what? No. Awkward Tunes? No. You do not get that get out of jail free card. You do not get a pass from me. Your remake sucks almost as much as the original video. Do the drawings objectively? Yes. It looks better. The drawings do look better, and there is sort of proper animation. There's actual lip syncing and animation. That is a good thing. However, it still looks bad. I don't really like the art style that much. It kind of just looks like Pokemon, like a bootleg Pokemon, so Digimon. But as well, the characters look exactly the same. They have the same exact problem where the classics look identical to the toys. And also, so there is a big problem in the remake that was also in the original. Can you guess what it is? Because I, you know, whine about it for like 3/4 of the video in the original review. Yep, reusing animation. Reusing animation is a huge problem in the original Shake It Off video. It literally happened every, like, you know, 2 seconds. Which is horrible. Don't reuse entire scenes. That's dumb. Now, for, like, you know, choruses, I can kind of see you, you know, just reusing the scenes. I can kind of, you kind of get a slide, but not fully. Not fully. You're sliding in a home base, but you barely touch it. So yeah, but basically entire scenes are reused in the original, and it is still a problem in the remake. There's literally entire scenes still, you know, reused in the remake. You literally just make an enhanced port version of the game. It's just an HD port of the original Awkward Tunes. It's not a remake at all. A remake is supposed to improve on things. This doesn't. Sure, it looks better, but that's it. It just looks better. There's nothing else to it. It's like, you know, having an unfrosted cupcake, okay? Okay? The original FNAF Shake It Off video was an unfrosted cupcake, and the remake is a unfrosted cupcake, but with wrapping on it. That's it. It just looks nicer than the original just unfrosted cupcake. There's no frosting on it, so it's not really edible. See, that's basically my analysis there. The remake gets a negative 8 out of 10. Or maybe just a 1. It probably just gets like a 1 out of 10, because it's still has problems that the original video still has. Well, at least the puppet actually does look like the puppet. I'll give you that. That the characters actually look like the characters, but, like, you know, still bad. All right, moving on. Now moving on to Sugar. Da 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 da. Honey, da da da. Proceeds to get into a plane crash with explosion. Anyways. So, what do I think of my review of Sugar's The Mangle? In my opinion, the review... Okay, there are some parts that I completely screwed up on, like talking about how choppy the run cycles are, and then I used an example from a Looney Tunes cartoon where Daffy Duck's running, but, like, it's... Daffy's literally doing a Naruto run, so, like, yeah. Then I also talk about how it's not animation, even though it is. Was I drunk? Was I smoking something? But... okay, so actually, the review portions I do genuinely think are decent outside of those examples. They're alright. They're infinitely better than the FNAF Shake It Off videos. So I would say, yeah, they're kind of good. They're alright. The actual video, I still think it's bad. The actual video itself, the mangle, is not that good at all. The song is just, I don't know, I don't really care for the song. But plot points and also the designs of the characters are bad. I know this is someone's early animations, but still, like, the Night Guard looks horrible. He is constantly off model, and there's even one point where he doesn't even has a face or hair. Like, you probably should include that on your character, okay, buddy? Buddy boy. And also, Mangle herself, she's a literal tube fox. She's a literal tube noodle shark fox thing. I'll just quote a comment I made on this video. How does video have 36 million views, a noodle pipe fox thing? Basically summed up my entire thoughts on the video. Thanks me back in 2 years ago, so back in 2019. But in actuality, okay, so the Mangle is bad. I would say, like, the animation is extraordinarily choppy in my opinion, and Mangle's design is really weird. It looks bad. I don't like it that she's just a giant tube. You know, there's a reason why she's called Mangle, right? It's because she's a mangled corpse of an animatronic, and then you make her look like, you know, this giant slither creature. Sure, make her like the same exact size of Godzilla and like breaking through the floors and stuff. Like, that's not Mangle. She crawls on the ceilings and the vents. She doesn't, you know, break through this stuff. Also, why is Foxy from FNAF 1 here? He just appears for the chorus. Like, why? Like, why? You couldn't make that, like, Wither Foxy, at least? If it was Wither Foxy, that would make more sense. But nope, it's just FNAF 1 Foxy, because why not? Screw you. You. Also, the big thing in the video is this. So, Mangle confronts the Night Guard, Jeremy Fitzgerald man, and she accidentally knocks off his hat, and then boom! She's like, oh, wait a minute, this guy's not the purple guy. So, basically, Jeremy Fitzgerald wearing the Night Guard hat reminds her of the purple guy, or as how Sugar likes to call him, the purple dude! The purple dude! Okay, but so you're telling me, if someone wears a security hat, Mangle's going to kill them? Because it reminds them of the purple guy? Even though, you know, the Night Guard hat was blue? Like a dark blue? Okay, yeah, that totally makes sense. You could have just made it something simple, like, gee, I don't know. No, he wears purple guy's uniform, just wears a Night Guard uniform that's purple, like how literally every single other FNAF animation back in the day did it. But, yeah, also Mangle just straight up kills Jeremy, which is, very shocking. I was expecting him to leave, but he doesn't. He literally dies. Was that the bite of 87? So, yeah, what do I think of my review overall? I'd say it was alright. To be honest, there was some jokes that were pretty funny, but I mess up a little too much. That kind of makes it unwatchable of my review. Reviews. I am messing so up so much. My script for this part literally just says, talk about bad the reviews is and how I effed up on saying then the videos themselves. You seriously couldn't, like, add more me. So, overall, the review portions are mediocre. The actual video is bad. Moving on to Just Gold. Alright, so moving on to Just Gold, my review portion. Okay, I'll straight up admit, I barely watched my review portions, because I felt like they probably would have been exactly the same, like, with the Mangle part, okay? To be honest, the Sugar review, I don't know if it's just my enthusiasm's kind of dripping away, but to be honest, the Sugar review is just kind of forgettable, in my opinion. Like, I completely forgot I reviewed these, two videos. It was back-to-back, like, overall, well, the Just Gold animation, to be honest, the drawings look nice for the most part. Despite the video coming out before the Mangle, so, how'd you mess up on that? I would say that, there's not really, you know, animation, technically. There's a couple of bits of actual animation, but, like, there's none at all. Also, it takes place in the FNAF 2 location, Golden Freddy has his FNAF 1 design, and Springtrap is here. Oh, yeah, that totally makes sense. Also, this purple guy drawing sucks. Springtrap's design just looks weird. Like, I never liked it. like, in my opinion. I don't like the big bushy eyebrows to make him look like Tom from the Chuck Jones era of Tom and Jerry. And what's with the stitching on his mouth? Like, I thought the stitching on his mouth was, like, to keep his mouth from flipping up and revealing his corpse. Because I personally think that would have been a really cool idea. You know, he takes off the string to scare the girl or something. But no, it's just, he takes it off and then it acts like a whip. And then, he's fine. Okay, whatever. But he also has the ability to activate the toy animatronics. Okay. Also, Golden Freddy's just here chilling on a pile of animatronic corpses. Okay, I'll admit that's a little cool. Cool. Yeah. Also, folks, I still don't know who this red animatronic is. Please, Sugar, help me understand your lore. But anyways, yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say for those two main videos. Now, I actually do talk about the weird FNAF SpongeBob animations for like 2 seconds. Yeah, those are really weird. I don't understand that. Those ones. And also, talk about the thumbnails. Now, the thumbnails are beautifully, drawn. Obviously, I'm assuming Sugar went back and redrawed the thumbnails for the videos. However, that is a huge negative, because Sugar obviously improved a crap ton over time, and now the thumbnails look infinitely better than the video. For example, like I used an example, Die in a Fire, where the Chica in the thumbnail looks gorgeous, while the Chica in the actual video just looks downright horrible. So yeah, is it a bad thing she redid the thumbnail? Yes, definitely. But overall, the videos are just, this review is just incredibly mediocre, extremely forgettable, or maybe I'm just want to go to sleep. Alright, now let's answer the biggest question of the day, the money-winning question here. Alright, last segment to review, take one, even though I'm doing this before reviewing the actual reviews. So, alright, so now I actually want to talk about some little known behind the scenes and just stuff about my reviews in general. Okay, so first of all, the making of my old reviews. How did I make my old reviews? Well, I'm going to tell you now. Okay, so basically I'll download the video from an unauthorized pirate website, then I would watch the video and have an audio recorder near me, and whenever I wanted to make a point, I would, pause that video. But the video obviously didn't have any audio, so you didn't have to deal with, like, weird echoing. And obviously this was a bad thing, because that meant I had to completely improvise all my points. And sometimes, like you saw, the points didn't make any sense. Any sense of the imagination. So yeah, next is the character stills. In the original reviews, I had Withered Freddy, and he was behind a vaporwave background. Then Jane decided to remake the stills for me. And he has gone on to say that he doesn't really like those old stills he made, and I don't like the stills either. I just don't like the idea of me being represented as Withered Freddy, because that's not who I want to be represented as. All right, talking about character stills, take two. Now let's talk about the character stills. In the AVHE Gone 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 video, I had these Freddy character stills that were with a Freddy behind a vaporwave background. And then in the FNAF... Alright, talking about character stills, take three. Take four. So, now getting into the character stills, in the AVAG Gone 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 video, I had these Withered Freddy character stills of him behind a vaporwave background, and then in the FNAF Shake It Off video, we got brand new stills of Withered Freddy, created by the one and only Jaden Plays Games Studios, or Jaden Does Stuff, or whatever he calls himself now. But, yeah, now to be honest, I don't like the old Withered Freddy stills, and I don't like the new Withered Freddy stills. The old Withered Freddy stills were kind of primitive, yeah, and the newer ones that were made lacked a lot in the background, and also kind of in variety as well. Like, there was not that many happy stills at all, and most of them were just angry, which you could say that kind of reflected the content at my time. And also, I don't know why Jaden decided to make the death still a reference to Family Guy. I feel like that kind of degrades that still, because it's referencing an old meme that aged like milk. Then I had two other stills, being the Yakko stills. Now, why did I have two stills of two separate characters? The Wither Freddy stills are supposed to be used for FNAF-related videos, and the Yakko one was supposed to be related to, like, you know, just other stuff that's not FNAF-related. I had these old Yakko stills, and then I didn't even get, like, one. I only had, like, one video with them in it, and then Jaden decided to remake those stills as well. And to be honest, the Yakko stills, the remade Yakko stills, do look a lot better than the original. I'll give them that. However, there was a big problem with the character stills, and that was, well, they didn't represent me. Like, on the internet, I don't want to represent myself as Wither Freddy or Yakko with a top hat smoking his cigar. Like, that's not me. I already have a persona. Now, actually, speaking of the ABAG Left Behind video, I was planning on actually including a brand new Sparky stills that would have been included in the video. I had a ton of these stills made, but sadly, the computer they were on, the old computer I used to have, that had the stills, the computer died. The laptop completely fried, and for some reason it was damaged beyond repair. So I had to get I got a new laptop. And sadly, obviously, those Sparky stills were on the old one, so I couldn't, use them. Which, to be honest, I guess was for the better. The only surviving Sparky still is one I posted on Twitter teasing the new video and stills. And I actually got kind of far into the video, but, whatever. Those, sadly, the remaining stills are forever lost, which kind of sucks. But, to be honest, that's probably a good thing that they were lost. Because I don't want to represent myself as Sparky, Wither Freddy, Yakko. I don't want to represent myself as those characters. I want to represent myself as me, Isaac Cook. And, okay, I'll admit, I want to make character stills of the Isaac Cook character, but, like, it's going to take a long time to make, and I kind of don't want to do it, so, lack of motivation, I guess. So, and besides, my drawings aren't the best, so, yeah, unless I can get someone to, like, and a good artist to make character stills for me, I'm just going to use gameplay footage of, like, some random game, so, commentators. So, yeah, sorry, guys. Now, let's get to the money, the big question, the money-winning question. Where are the reviews? Why have I basically stopped making reviews and my channel has basically dissolved into an animation channel? Well, because even though I do want to make reviews, reviews take a really long time to make, in my opinion, and it's really hard to come up with stuff to review. I do have an idea for, like, reviewing other FNAF-related channels like AngryJohn100, though I don't feel like doing it. It's basically just motivation. I don't have the motivation to do it. While animations, it's simple. If I have an idea for an animation, if I feel like the animation is good, I'll make it. And with animation, you can improve on it kind of easily, in my opinion, compared to reviews. Because, you don't need, like, a big budget stuff like a mic and a studio, soundproof studio. I'm literally sitting in this room recording it where I, go to sleep and have my Chuck E. Cheese plush and a Donald Duck cutout. But, but with animation, you can improve on it just with your computer. You can just improve over time. Obviously, you might need to have, like, a, high-ranking computer to run SFM or something like that, but, I have a good enough computer to do that. I know it's not a computer. It's a laptop, okay? Be quiet. But yeah, that's the main reason. They take way too long to make. I sometimes don't have ideas for reviews, and the motivation to push and do the reviews, I don't have. But that's really about it. Now, guys, don't worry. Since I got a proper good mic, I might actually start doing reviews more often. And I also finally got away to making a script. Originally, obviously, like I stated, I, didn't use scripts back in the day. But now, I finally learned a way to properly improvise scripts. I did eventually start doing scripts, but they made me sound pretty robotic. Even though I already kind of sound robotic, to be honest. But I finally, got a way to using a script, but also keeping it improvised, sort of, and having fun. But, yeah. I don't know when the next review thing will come out. Actually, it might come out kind of soon. You know that Five Nights at Chuck E. Cheese review I made, and I teased that I was going to do a remake? Yeah, me and Jaden, yes, Jaden's going to be in the video, sorry to spoil it, have finished the audio for that review. Keep in mind, it's not really, you know, a really good review, like, it's not really critiquing the game that well, but, I don't know, I still think it would be fun to, you know, show. So, see you guys later. Thank you guys so much for watching. Kind of rambling on too much. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.